Well, good day, everybody. It's me, Engconn, along with, well, yeah, you know it, Chibarashka, who's my luck charm and always by my side. And, well, you know, he's just a great companion. And, well, he's going to do some cooking with me today. And in this video, we are going to do a little crafting so we understand how things work. So we're at the cottage, and the reason why I like to come to the cottage a few times, as I mentioned in the first video, I like to come here and get the spare float tackle, so you can either E, key, open your house, Y to get extra float, or G to get spin. If you get the spin, you're going to end up with another reel, which you don't need. I usually just take the one extra reel, but I like to get the spare spin tackle, and it's really good because it says I succeeded. And the reason why is I absolutely love the feather float. So you can come in here once a day, and so if you recommend it, as I mentioned in the first video that I made in the series, that if you fish a few in-game hours, you can have three or four of these. I really enjoy these floats a lot. They're really sensitive and nice, and good reaction time. I really like working with them. Plus, they're like 1 gram. It's like fantastic stuff, because most stuff in the stores are 2 or 3 or higher. So these ones are super, super cool. Okay, so anyway, I always do this when I come to the cafe, and of course you will get the spare sinkers and a little line for it. So we go to our inventory, we're going to have lines, so you start getting a bunch of these, and you could use them for crafting, like leaders for, you know, building some experience points. They're not like super great, or you could just discard them, or whatever you want. But I also like that you also get the sinkers, you see, so you can start getting a set of weights, and if you get your lines gone, well, that's the way it goes. And it's possible to send them other players if they're missing sinkers, so you can give them a gift as well. So if you have a premium account, of course, because you can't send things without premium account. That's the thing about the one little perk that they give you, and you're able to send things to other players. Or they can send things to you, but you can't send out or send messages in-game either. So that's the other thing you need to think about, that if you want to have in-game chat, it's also to have premium. Okay, so there's the plug for that one. Okay, so we are, this gazebo does nothing, and as I mentioned, you see by my picture again, that little yellow bar in the second one, that is my health meter, but you see that energy just will not get any higher, and, you know, I pick up my darn shovel and just can't get there. I mean, that's just, and that's why, and the older video said, oh, buy the shovel. Yeah, when I did that, I couldn't use it for a long time. It was like I could have put that silver into food or something like that. So if you are going to buy the shovel, do it after you buy your food gear, because until you can get your energy bar up, and then you hit your backspace button, and of course you press your U key, and you can allocate what you want for a hotkey. To do that. Now they've introduced in the last update 2 more, so I'm not, of course, going to get premium on this one because my other account I already have, and I won't pay for 2 accounts. But for the functionality for what I'm doing, the 5 is more than enough for what I need for how I fish anyway. Okay, so let's get crafting. Quite important here. And so if you bought your piece of wood, you use 1 piece of wood per fire, which is about almost a day's worth of burning. So if it's 7 o'clock in the morning, this should last most of the day until the new day at least. So you press your Y key, you start the fire, and now it says E for crafting. It's a little bit hard to see, but it says E for crafting. Here you've got the smokehouse. You won't get to do that for quite a while yet. So you press E, takes you, there you go. So now we can start baking potatoes. I want to look at the cocoa right away. Yeah, we need condensed milk. So you can put your mouse over that, and it says you got 1 piece here, but you click on the picture, it says I have 3 pieces. So I can technically make 18 drinks, 3 thermoses, but the quality is what's going to be interesting. So we're going to cancel this for now. And then here, that means I'm going to have 10 pieces. I'll have 7 left. When I'm done, I'll be running out of milk. That's why it's a little expensive, but the cocoa for a new player, I think, is a really good investment, because it does the comfort and the energy kind of a balance. So it's not, this coffee is more energy, tea is more comfort, but the higher your comfort, more stabilized your energy. So it's a nice way to kind of look at it in this aspect. Okay. So, not to get any failures to start, we are going to do some baked potatoes. So you see I've got 6 pieces, so it's 6 times 5, so I have 30 pieces of potato. We confirm that, and we're going to make one. So this is going to be our first part of our recipe. There we go. I got a 9 out of a 10, so this is good quality, like really good. You get 9, 8, 8, 9 tenths, and I just went 2%. Now, if you have premium, you paid the subscription, you'd be getting bonuses and extra points, and you get a happy hour, and it's really, really good. So, but I'm not worried about that. So right now, this 0.2 is okay. Then, to show you something, is when you're cooking, some recipes will require, so you don't want to use all 5 potatoes, you can break them down in segments, like some recipes you'll be cooking fish in the future with potatoes, so you don't want to take all 5, you can make like 2 or 3 and separate them. So I want to separate them, I click on this one again and I can make, and then I can make a little row of potatoes for future investment. Now I'm up to 4. Oh, quality though. This is a bad potato because if I eat this, it'll do something for me, but not as good as if it was 9. And that's going to happen. You're going to have like a good balance. So generally, I try to eat all my bad food first and then keep the good stuff for when I really need it. If I got a big fish on or if it's a bad weather, you know, then use your quality drinks to get your energies back. So now when you look, now it says I have 2 pieces of 4. So now I want to go to the 4, just to give you an example. This is what you'd be doing in the future. And also, there's a thing called making potatoes in the baits, which we'll do the craft baits on another video, okay? So I'm up to 6%, and it does take a while, and it's not always 2%, 0.2%. It can only be 1 sometimes. The higher you get, the more difficult. All right, I'm going to bake this one 3 more times. Now that you got the idea how it goes, so if I'm going to be making a fish dinner, I usually use 2 to 3 potatoes. Now, if you're going to be crafting baits, if you use a full potato, you get the full potential, like 30 or 40 pieces. If you decide to craft 3, you might get a lower boost in your percentage of making, but you'll end up with less pieces. So a lot of people say, oh, just craft your 1 or 2, don't use them. It's better just crack all 5 off and you'll get a better bonus. I usually do this breakdown because a lot of the future cookings will require potatoes and ham, potatoes and fish. You don't need to have to slap a whole 5 potatoes because it is gets a little expensive. It's $190 for 5. So if you know how to do the crafting here, I can make 3 from this one and simply like that. So this is how the potato works. Simply, that's all you need. Fire and a potato. So this now is good for your health. It gives you a good boost. And now we're going to go into tea. See, you need the kettle, guys. Without the kettle, you can't make the tea. You click on here. I've got 2 packs, which means 2 pieces. That means I got 20. I use 1. I go on like that, and now I'm going to make it. There it is. Now the tea is going to build my comfort level. There we go. 8 out of 10. Ooh, I got 1% now. I got plus 2 in cooking. See? So it starts to go. Now, to choose which one, I don't want to crack the new one, you click on this one and you can now make all the teas. You can make 5 teas or all the 10 if you want. See, 2 out of 10, this is a bad one, though you're getting cooking aspects. So I'm just going to make 5 here and see what qualities I get. Oh boy, 1 out of 10, that's bad. Yeah, see, well, there's your investment as a new player. Hire your process of matching your cooking percentage gets higher, your tea qualities and stuff will get better. So you'll be drinking a little more tea a little more often, but at least your crafting skills will get better and better. So we'll do 5, 2 out of 10. Yeah, that's bad. So at least it helps in one aspect. Okay, 5. This is much better. So we're at 2% cooking now. It does take a long time to be leveling up. What do we have left here? 4? Okay, I'm going to make the all 4 anyway. And as I said before, it has generally that when I'm eating or drinking, I use all of my bad stuff. Don't discard it. You have the choice to discard it, but don't do it. Just drink it anyway. You'll get something from it, you know, not its maximum best. All right, so at least we're now getting skill points. Okay, I got 2.6 now. So that's only doing a few eggs. We have 1 left. Make sure you click on it. I'm not going to cook all of it. At least let's make the video to show how it goes. 7 out of 10. So out of that, I did pretty good. Now, the next thing is, I can't make coffee. I do have the item, but because coffee is 300 silver, and as a new player, well, I'm just prepared for when I go to Old Berg that at least I might be able to buy it, or I will end up buying coffee at some point. Or someone may give it to you too, right? Because it's possible sent to another player. Maybe somebody was, hey, I can send you a can of coffee. So, who knows, okay? But definitely buy that coffee maker. Cocoa we had made, so we got three pieces here. And we're going to click on that, and we're going to make cocoa now. Yep, so we're going to make three cocos, and we're going to make. There we are. So you need the kettle for that, like the tea and boiling the aid. And that's why that kettle, 3 out of 10. Let's make all three. So, you know, all together, you pay a little bit for the milk. Okay, 3 out of 10. You know, that's basically for a new player, this is what you're going to end up with. Okay, 3 out of 10, that's it. So now I'm out of milk, and it's 2-something for the condensed milk. But at least this will boost your comfort, and so save this more for the rainy day, or if you got like very tired, or if you are, you know, trying to get some worms, then you can do it that way. Next most important, again, the kettle, guys. You see why it's important? All your recipes. Let's cook 10 eggs today, okay? And you will get a failure, by the way, too, guys. It's probably going to happen here. You're going to go, oops. Yeah, nothing like, what do you mean I can't boil an egg, right? So I got 3 out of 10. That's one. Let's make two. We'll see if we get a failure here. Right, there's two. And it does happen sometimes. And I had even 3 consecutive fails. When that happens, that's just like, you go, man. Yeah. So, we got a new achievement. At last, we'll warm up. So now you get achievements for doing things. Okay? So we got a 4. And we got enough is enough. Look at that. See, the achievements are coming. We got 4.4%. We can still make, oh, let's make 5 more eggs. I say we'll make, and the eggs actually help you, give you a really good boost of energy as well, in health, and a little bit in the energy, but the health is what it keeps up. So if your health is good, then your energy will stabilize. Otherwise, it's going fast. All right, let's cook a little more here. But most important is the marshmallow, or you can invest in the vending machine, buy a couple of drinks, or you can go into the grocery store and buy the lemonade, but it's a little bit longer to recover, but it is possible to get your energy bar up, but it'll take a little extra work. So it's better by doing it by the coffees and teas. 5.1%, and one left. Okay, we'll make one more here. There we go. So, but this is the idea about crafting, guys. It's kind of important that you're going to be doing your food. And see, right now we're locked out. So again, to make macaroni, you won't know what the recipe is, you see. And until you make a fire, just like sausage on a stick, right? Oh, we just need sausages. You click on to that. I've got 30 sausages. Okay, so we're going to cook 10 of them. And these help you too, just kind of keep the health bar up. It doesn't do anything hard for your energy or comfort, but if you keep your health up, at least you stabilize your health bar. Okay, now we're going to make. So now I clicked 2, and I go back in here now. So it's still going to maintain on this one. We can do 8 more. I'm hoping to get a failure here, so you see that it does happen. All right, so we got a 4 quality. And either that, because I'm making a video, I might have all perfect cooking probably. That's probably what's going to happen. And then when I go offline, it's going to be, oh, fail, fail, fail. That's usually what happens. My RNG is just crazy in this fishing endeavor here. All right. Now we got another achievement. Taste is not the most important thing. So, and of course, I love achievements. What do we got left here? 4 more pieces. Okay. Do I get a failure? Come on. Do I get a failure? Da-dum-da-dum-da-dum. 4 out of 6. Nope. Okay, let's make. We've got 3 more, 2 more. All right. Ooh, 9 out of 10. I've got a good one. So that one's really gonna, it will help me satisfy, because more better the food, the better the health bar stuff maintains. Okay, we didn't get a 10 out of 10, I think, but let's give it a go. So unfortunately, I can't cook marshmallows because I can't afford them, and the new players, well, we won't be able to get there. So that's all the food that you can make right now. And then when you press your N key, you're able to craft The baits, we can do this. This is for your bait crafting. And if you're going to be doing lures, they open the first two for quality because we did the skills. You need the leader tools, which is 380 something silver to make leaders. And food, I can't do this yet because we still need to unlock the ability, which when you go into the crafting, you can go to example, I go here and you can go into the skills or statistics, and then you go into cooking, and to get the cucumbers we need 10%. We're already at 7.3, so once you start making cucumbers, then you can do, and this is where the frying pan comes in, so you're not too far. So I recommend getting that frying pan fairly soon, is making good fish dinners, and then if you're catching the required fish, instead of like selling it, you can be using it for crafting versus throwing it back. So now we're going to give it a test, and I will take because see now my health is behind my picture. You press the T key and as example I'm gonna take the 3 out of 6 cocoa, just to see what happens here. And you see that energy bar now on the top will start to grow. It takes a little, you know, a few seconds, not an instantaneous thing. And because my comfort is low, I'm going to take my cheapest tea. And because the quality is not very good, now you see the comfort, the bottom bar is almost equal to my life bar. But you see my energy, now look at that, energy has gone up. There you go. Look at that. Now, of course, the hunger meter doesn't grow so much because I'm drinking and eating low-quality food. But the main thing is get that energy bar up. Now, guys, you see the energy bar has just gone up. Now I can go, this will be the first time I'll ever get to use my shovel. So it is very important to try to have the cocoa, have the tea. Marshmallows are good. And we're going to dig for worms, right? So what, we go into the garden. Hey, here we go. Let's go into the garden. Now we're going to get my shovel out, and I should be able to dig. There it is. Boom. And I got 3 worms. Harvesting is now good. I got 4.4%. So, unfortunately, the energy bar goes right down to the red. It will recover slowly on the quality, but because I'm still hungry, I can take the tea so I can have a good quality. So I generally will eat all of my bad or less cheaper foods. Like here, one quality. Let's get rid of the sausage stick. And this will help recover your health back. Let's take another one. You can get rid of them. See, now you'll start seeing the orange bar come out from behind my video face here. And now let it power up a little bit. And now again, to get the comfort, because we don't have the coffee, the tea does help, but our comfort level is already up. But you'll start seeing, because we're eating good food, the fact your comfort level's up, your energy bar will come back substantially better. So in this case, you could like eat an egg or something like in good quality, or you can just simply, hey, I'm going to have another chocolate, and though it does the comfort, but you see your energy bar goes up. So it's a little bit of expensive investment, but if you're digging for worms, it's the best way. And you see it takes a couple of minutes to have this happen. That's why I recommend that you try at least do some crafting, get those important components before you start worrying about fishing and other things. Or like buying lures and stuff like that. At least get this part done. So it's really good to be fishing in here a few days. And also, as I mentioned before, you can press your escape key and you can go to the records and rating, and you can go into your region, because these are all the fish in this lake. And if, let's say, you're from France, right, you can try to get that 447 fish, because this one was done in 2020, and you'll have this point in the pond, and you'll have the record rating stay, because it's up like that. But now if you go to absolute records, this is a global thing for all the bodies of water. But for the cottage pond, if you want to put your name up here, you need to target these fish and try to do it. So you just see that there's quite a bit of date differences. Some people do try to do it. I'll show you the baits wasn't on, but you got to look at the dates though, guys. Now they got the top 5 in here as well. So this is like the ultimate top. And there's a thing called the weekly, And the weekly, of course, when we did the first video, it's all the fish, but you can see what they're biting, more or less where they're biting. They tell you kind of the lake and things like that. So it gives you an idea. So I'm from the Russia CIS country. I'm going to go to the cottage pond, and I need to catch a 482 sleeper. I need a 7.028 to get myself permanently on this open board for this body of water. So this is how it works, guys. You can check, though, on this body of water in the region, but the absolute records, well, this is a whole global. And this records is for bottom feeding and casting. Ultralight is ultralight, and telescopic is your tele stick. So if you come in here with a tele stick, well, this is what you get for the cottage pond. You see, they're all different for all different regions. Germany is 482, other region 493, you see. But to get your permanent name in your region, you know, you can come and target this, which I plan to do this in mine actually one day. I'm going to come in and try to get the sleeper, try to get the tench, you know, just get my name up here. Why not, right? And then it comes by the top five. So if you play somewhere in there, that's pretty cool. Okay, that's how that works. So now you see our health just by giving you the video. I can come in again and, oh, you know what? I'm going to dig for some more worms. You see? That's the only way you can do it, guys. There it is. I got 12 pieces. Harvesting also now has gone up. And then I can go press my escape. Or is it? No, press the O key on the keyboard and you get your skills. And now you see cooking is 7. And bait harvesting now starting to grow because I can use my shovel now. Okay, so we're going to end this video here, guys. It gives you a good concept why it's important for new players to at least try to save a bit of your silver at the beginning. I spent, you know, 20, 30 silver. At least now I'm going to start harvesting and things like that and not set any points. And I will try to find out what is for the reset, but as I recommended in the previous video, you know, be cautious on your points because you really got to know which way you want the fish. So you get to try the lake and the mosquito and river fishing, because every map there's lake and river, and you know, if you might like one more than, you know, like style more than the other, then you'll be frequenting that those bodies of water more often. So Jabrashka and I say goodbye for now. Hope you enjoyed. Hope it helps. And also set the, we'll put the descriptions in the links below for Skillful to help for some great great advice in the Discord, and as well as I stream every day on the Daily Chronicles. You can join me on the Twitch and or make a comment and do whatever you'd like to find out any information. And please like or dislike or share with your friends the videos, or invite your friends to play the game as well, because it's really, really fun. It's very challenging. So hope you enjoy. And we'll see you in the next vid.